to you.
Hi, my name is Rayhan Mohammed. I'm 25. I was born in London and I'm a Muslim. I love birthdays. And for me, it's just a time to kind of have some fun. And when you look around, it's really nice to know that you've got people that love you and care about you. For me, it's difficult because, you know, I have one birthday with my family, which is really lovely and sweet, and there's something special about being with your family on that day. But there's also a time when I'm with my friends and I can really just be myself and laugh and really celebrate it properly. I feel like I don't celebrate it as much as I'd like to at home, purely because I don't want to show any kind of, I don't want to give anything away, or, you know, I always worry about my mannerisms or the way I react to things. So there are pros and there are cons to the religion that I've been brought up with, and, you know, being a part of Islam or being in a Muslim household. I've been growing up to know that it is a very peaceful and loving religion, and it comes with beautiful teachings to being a good person. For me, it's difficult because to be gay and Muslim is forbidden. I hated school. I never liked school at all. I always used to scream and throw tantrums. My grandmother used to try and just get me in my uniform and get me out. When my grandmother used to pick me up, she'd take me home, and the only films I would ever watch was The Lion King and Toy Story, and I was obsessed. She still always brings it up to this day, how I was so obsessed, and she misses those days of when I would just sit there eating cheese sandwiches and watching Disney films. My mum has always been so strong in everything that she's gone through to raise us, to raise me and my brother, and give us the best she could give us, you know? You know, she went out to work all the time. I was being brought up by my grandparents, so in a way she worked all the time so that we could get a good education, we can get all the gadgets that we wanted. And yeah, I think my relationship with my mum is very special, and she's been very protective over me. And my brother, I don't know, I feel like he he's mentioned before where he always feels like I'm the golden child, and he never has been, where I think that's the other way around. My grandfather's a very religious man. He's a good man, but he's very strict, very religious. So I grew up, and where he would want me to pray, and I would be like, no, I don't want to do this. I want to watch TV. He would be very angry, and I think the way he kind of showed religion to me was as if it wasn't fun, or if it wasn't a good, it wasn't exciting, you know, I wasn't passionate about it. So I guess just because of how strict he was, I always had that distance between him in a way, whereas my grandmother would teach me in a more kinder, sweeter way. And make me pray next to her and learn, you know. My relationship with God, in a way, has been special. Growing up, and I've needed someone to kind of just talk to or let my feelings out to. It was kind of a coping mechanism for me. It was someone to talk to. It hasn't been intensely religious as such, but it's been that comfort in my life, that feeling of there being someone watching over me or caring for me in a way. And I've kind of, you know, growing up as a Muslim, you're born into that faith. You know, you don't choose what faith you're born into. And so it's part of my identity, it's part of who I am, being a Muslim. By liking men, I'm going against a big part of what I've grown up with. I'm going against my family. And so that's always going to be a difficult decision. When I meet a guy, there is a part of me that obviously wants to get to know this person and be with this person, but there's a small tiny part of me that will always feel a sense of guilt, because if I choose to go through with being with a man, I'm always going to end up letting someone down. Whether I choose to or don't choose to. I either let myself down by not doing it, or I let my family down, or my beliefs, or their beliefs. I think the first time I got caught out was with my cousin. It was around the time when I started talking about it, and I was talking to my friend Luke over Facebook chat. And I left my laptop screen open and went to the toilet. And my cousin was in the living room and looked at the laptop. And next thing you know, he saw that I was talking about this guy. And that was the first time when my heart just dropped and I felt sick. And I was like, what the fuck? Sorry, I just saw. but it's a scary moment. It was a really scary moment. But he was open to understanding it, which was interesting. We kind of sat down in the garden and we talked about it. And he, you know, I think every reaction is always, are you sure? Have you ever been with a girl? Just those classic questions that are a bit like, I mean, how do you know? When my brother found out, I could see he was in shock. And the only thing he said was that it needs to stop and it's going to change. And this is just a phase. I have managed to convince him that it's not like that anymore. I've lied about this because I'm not at a place in my life where people like my brother or people that close to me, like my mother or anyone, could know this, because it's huge. I live two very different lives. One life where I'm straight and I'm Muslim and I'm Indian and I'm with my family. And the other life where I'm also Indian and Muslim, but I'm gay. And I'm with my friends and I'm more confident and I'm happier.
End of day.
It all said and done. Do you know what I mean?
What is that you're drinking?
This.
Have you seen the little sock?
This is a leffe. The leffe. How do you say it?
I think Les sings a song.
Do me what?
Do me do me
bon. Do me bon. Do me bon.
What lacks in the other life is that confidence and that happiness, because I'm just constantly not really being myself. My expressions and my mannerisms and the way I talk is very different to when I'm just being me. It was my first Pride ever. I went to Pride for the first time, and I think that was the moment. We all went to the festival place after the parade. And I think even seeing the parade, it was the first eye-opener was seeing the community of LGBT Muslims walking down with their banner. And I was like, whoa, it's not just me. Who are these people? I looked around and these thousands and thousands of people were just celebrating in a way, me or and this community. They were really like celebrating us. And then we went to the kind of festival area, and before the big act came on, there was this 1 minute silence. And the entire festival was just quiet. And then up on the screen it was this kind of slideshow of all the people in the world that have been killed or hurt for being gay or being imprisoned, and showed all these names and faces, and it was one after the other for this 1 minute. And that was the moment when I realized I'm so lucky to be standing here right now with the people that I'm friends with, and I'm surrounded by these thousands of people who are just celebrating it and are supportive of it. How can I be against it anymore? How can I go against that when there are people out there that are being killed for it? The only tip that I could share to other gay Muslims is that, one, you're not alone. And when times get really dark and you feel alone, you'll never be alone, because there are so many support groups and communities out there that can help you. There are so many people that surround you, friends, that could help you. So feeling alone is the biggest thing and the hardest thing to overcome, but you're not. And I think you don't need to struggle too hard or think too hard into that. The other tip I'd say is really discover who you are. Take that time to learn about yourself. Because going, you know, head in, go, right, family, I'm gay, that, you know, coming from this background, that could have really bad circumstances. So there has to be a way to do that, because you're growing up in a very strict environment religiously. So take your time. Don't just go into it. Really understand yourself, learn about yourself, and then when you're ready, just do it. Time is key to really doing this. Do it, but take your time. I've always been told that if you just wish for something, or if you pray for something, then one day it will happen. It's just knowing that things will get better.